Quindi?
This look still okay, and for me still good, in good condition. So next, for the first season, I think this the clothing is still good. I can no need to remove, no need to replace the new one. The second one still in good condition, and the spring still strong for me. And then the diaphragm, this one for me still in good condition, no need to replace. And this the filter inside the this still okay. And the O-ring, this one still for me still better, no need to change, still okay.
We need to change for the good roads for before this one. Can see this one. It and then after that we push the road. Okay. The road. And then alright. So this data, we can see here for after 39. You see, this one 39. So that's all for the road. We'll be right back.
the master cylinder part D is a reservoir. Okay, when we can maybe can look here, we have a pump here. Okay, this is a fluid indicator, so the driver will know when the brake fluid is low. Okay, next this is a reservoir filter. Okay, this is a reservoir oil cap. Okay, now we look at this is the master cylinder body. You can look it in a good condition. Okay, this is a upper seal. Okay, we look at this is secondary seal. It have spring and seal. Okay, the spring is in a good condition because it can return to the place. This is a primary shaft. It has a seal. Seal is in good condition. We have spread. Okay, look at another part.
So in this lab, they have 4 questions. So the first question is, based on the finding, what is the effect of push rod and length to brake performance? So the answer for the question 1 is, extensive push rod length can then eliminate the ability of the cylinder to do compression. Naturally, this can cause limiting for the poor performance too in some case, the engine not to start or even run. So for the question 2, name type of brake oil you use for your car. Can different type of brake oil be used and why? So my car use the DOT 3. Can the different type of brake oil be used why? So none of the different type of brake fluid should be mixed. They can react badly with each other and corrode your brake system. So for the third question, name hydraulic tube that connect to the master cylinder and where all the tubes are connected. So where is the master cylinder found? For minor brake, the master cylinder is attached directly to the firewheel and linked to the brake pedal. In power assistant brake, the master cylinder is attached to a brake booster, which supply more power to the braking system. Brake lines connect the operation device such as the brake master cylinder to the hydraulic component of the wheel brake. Brake posts are used as flexible kinetic pipe in all moving area between the body and the chassis. So for the last question, what is the function diagram? So the function of the diagram is to explain you the compressed air pressure and operate the S cam shoes and there will be the brake. So that's all for question in lab 2. Thank you.
In conclusion, we can identify the master cylinder part and did some inspection on master cylinder condition. The important of this service are for our safety and others. Furthermore, we learn the correct method to disassemble and assemble the master cylinder.